Hi, what's up, and welcome to this new lesson by me, Rajit Krishnayar. And in this lesson, we'll start off with a new chapter of wave optics. So in my previous six lessons, we discussed questions from geometrical optics. Now we'll move on to a new chapter of wave optics, and my next chapter will be electrostatics. Alright, so in this lesson, we'll see questions based on the concept of polarization, resolving power of a microscope, and we'll also see two questions from Young's double slit experiment. So without any further delay, let's begin. And before we begin, let me, as usual, briefly introduce myself for all those who are viewing my video for the first time. So I did my BTech in Electrical Engineering from IIT Madras. I graduated in 2014, and I also secured All India rank 321 and 355 in the IIT JEE advanced exam as well as the JEE main exam back in the year 2010. And I currently teach for competitive exams like JEE, NEET, KVPWA, Olympiads at Resonance Kota. And if you would like to follow me, you can follow me at this link, www.unacademy.com/user/@RKN. All right, so here we go. So first question is actually based on polarization. It was very recently asked in NEET 2017. So the question goes as follows. Two polaroids P1 and P2 are placed with their axis perpendicular to each other. The unpolarized light I0 of intensity I0 is incident on P1. A third polaroid P3 is kept between P1 and P2 such that its axis makes an angle 45 degree with that of P1. The intensity of the transmitted light through P2 is, the options are I0 by 4, I0 by 8, I0 by 16, and I0 by 2. Now, here, it's basically based on the intensity of light passing through a polaroid. So as usual, please pause the video, attempt the question, and then we'll discuss the solution. Alright, so I hope that you have attempted the question. Now, basically, in order to solve this question, you need two concepts. Okay, you need to understand two concepts, and these two concepts are as follows. First, you need to know what is the intensity of an unpolarized light when it is passed through a polaroid. Secondly, you should also know what happens to the intensity of a polarized light when passed through a polaroid. Okay, these two are very different things. So when you pass an unpolarized light, basically a light in which intensities or waves are spread in all the directions, okay, all the directions are basically equal, that is an unpolarized light. So when that passes through a polaroid, you only get half the light, that is, you get only half the light intensity passing through the polaroid. The rest of the half is actually blocked. Now, second case is when a polarized light is passed through a polaroid, only cos square theta factor passes through, and rest is blocked. So I becomes I0, which is the light incident, into cos square theta. Now the theta is the angle made by the polarization of the light and the axis of the polaroid. Now here what is happening is P1 and P2 are placed such that their axes are perpendicular to each other, and in between them P3 is kept. Okay, P3 is kept like this, 45 degree. Now first light is incident on P1, and when it passes through P1, it automatically becomes half, like we have previously discussed, because initially it was unpolarized. Now, since it has already passed through 1, it becomes polarized, right? Now, you'll have to use this formula because it's a polarized light. So, when passing through P3, it is previously polarized by P1 at an angle 45 degree. So, you have to multiply it by the term cos square 45 degree. Then again, this new polarized light, which will be of this much intensity, that is I0 into half into cos square 45 degree, will again encounter a polaroid kept at 45 degree to the axis of polarization. So, you have to again multiply it by cos square 45 degree. And when you substitute the value of cos square 45 degree, which is half and half, so you'll get I0 by 8. So, I0 by 8 will be the correct answer, option B. So I hope that you understand that it's basically a three-step answer. You can do it in one step by, just multiplying with all the factors that, it gets multiplied with, and you can directly write answer in one single shot. So that's how you solve this question quickly. Let's move on to the next one. This question was also asked very recently, that is NEET 2017. It was based on resolving power. The question goes as follows. The ratio of resolving power of a microscope for lights of wavelength lambda 1, 4000 angstrom, and lambda 2, 6000 angstrom is, option A, B, C, D are given, and the ratios are given. So you need to find the ratio of resolving power. So as usual, pause the video, attempt the question, and then we'll discuss the solution. All right, so I hope that you have attempted the question. So in order to solve this question, you need to know what a resolving power of microscope is and what is the formula, more importantly. So the resolving power of a microscope is given as follows. So 2 mu sine theta by lambda, where mu is the refractive index of the medium that is between the object and the objective of the microscope. Sine theta is the angle made by the cone. And half angle made by the cone, and lambda is the wavelength of light used for illumination. Now here we are only concerned with lambda, so we can directly say from this formula that resolving power is inversely proportional to lambda. So the ratio of resolving powers will be the inverse of the ratio of wavelengths. So RP1 by RP2 will be equal to lambda 2 by lambda 1 because it's inverse ratio. So RP1 by RP2 is equal to lambda 2 by lambda 1. We know the value of lambda 2 and lambda 1. You just substitute it and resolving power ratio comes out to be 3:2. Now, similar questions can be asked in future for resolving power of telescope. For that also, you need to know that the formula is similar, but you know, slightly different. It is D upon 1.22 lambda, where lambda is the wavelength of the light used and D is actually the diameter of the aperture. Here the angle does not matter and the mu does not really matter for telescope. It is D divided by 1.22 lambda. So keep this in mind. You know, similar question can be asked for telescope as well. If the question gives only lambda as the values, then the formula for solving remains exactly the same. Let's move on to the next question. Now the next question goes as follows. A Young's double slit experiment is first performed in air and then in a medium other than air. It is found that 8th bright fringe in a medium lies where 5th dark fringe lies in air. The refractive index of a medium is nearly. Now these are the options. You have to identify the correct option. As usual, pause the video, attempt the question, and then we'll discuss the solution. All right, now it's a very good question because you need to know a lot of concepts in order to answer this question correctly. First of all, you need to know what a fringe width is. You need to know what effect or what is the effect of refractive index on fringe width and how does lambda depend on refractive index. These are some basic concepts that you need to know. Now, if I write the formula of beta, that is fringe width, which is equal to lambda capital D by small d, you can clearly see how a fringe width depends on lambda. Now, remember, so suppose the original fringe width was beta. And when you change the refractive index here, the new fringe width becomes beta dash. Okay. So it says it is found that 8th bright fringe in a medium lies where 5th dark fringe lies in air. So 5th dark fringe will actually lie between 4th bright fringe and 5th bright fringe. All right. So that's where it will lie. So it will be actually at 4.5 beta and 8th bright fringe will lie at 8 beta dash. Why beta dash? Because it is in a medium. So the beta will change. So when you just simply substitute it by that formula and you can write the only thing that changes when you change the medium is that lambda will change. That's the only thing that will change because capital D and small d, that is distance between the sources as well as the geometrical distance between the screen and the sources will remain the same. Only lambda changes because we know that lambda will become lambda by n in a medium of n. So when you substitute in the values, this all these other variables get cancelled and when you calculate, it comes out to be 16/9, which is in other words 1.78. So C will be your correct option. Now let's see one more question on YDSC. The intensity is at the maximum in a Young's double slit experiment is I naught. Distance between the two slit, small d is equal to 5 lambda, where lambda is the wavelength of the light used in the experiment. What will be the intensity in front of one of the slits on a screen placed at a distance capital D is equal to 10 small d? The options are as follows. And as usual, pause the video, attempt the question, and then we'll discuss the solution. Alright, now in this question, the two things that you need to know is, first is calculation of phase difference at any point, if you know the path difference. And secondly, you need to be able to calculate the intensity if you have the phase difference given at any point. Okay, that's the question basically. Now it is given that, you know, the distance between the two slits is 5 lambda. So I have drawn the diagram like this. the distance between the two of them is 5 lambda, and the distance between the screen and the source is 10d. Now each d is given to be 5 lambda, so it becomes 50 lambda. All right. Now the central bright fringe will be formed here, and you want to find in question is what will be the intensity in front of one of the slits. Now let's take this slit as one of the slit, and in front of it we need to find, what do we need to find? We need to find the intensity here. Now you can clearly see at this point, so it is approximately 2.5 lambda far from the central maxima, and we can also find beta. Beta is basically the fringe width. When you calculate, it comes out to be 10 lambda. Now, phase difference, if you remember the formula, it can be simply calculated by y divided by beta into 2 pi. Remember this. At any point, if you need to calculate phase difference, you can use this formula. As long as this distance is much, much bigger than this small distance, you can use this approximation that y divided by beta into 2 lambda. It is similar to, you know, x upon lambda into 2 pi that you use in waves. So phi is equal to, when you substitute the values, you'll get pi by 2. Now, since you know the phase difference, you can calculate the intensity using this formula. That intensity is I max into cos square theta by 2 or phi by 2. Now here phi is equal to pi by 2. When you substitute, you can calculate, it becomes I is equal to I naught by 2, where I naught is the maximum intensity, that is central maximum. So remember, wave optics and especially YDSE, that is Young's double slit experiment, is a part of physics where you need to remember a lot of formulas. So if you remember the formulas, you can directly answer the question. All right. So I hope you really like this lesson, and sorry for the delay. I have been really busy in my, you know, day-to-day work. So that why there was a gap between my previous lessons and this lesson. And anyways, I hope you really like this lesson. If you did, then please rate, review and recommend this lesson. You can follow me by clicking this button. You can enroll in this course if you would like to, and you can upload this video if you like this lesson. And if you have any queries, doubt and feedback, please comment away in the comment section. And now there is a new feature on Unacademy where you can message me personally as well. I'll try to respond to you as soon as possible. And you can also share this video so that those who cannot afford quality coaching are not left behind. And finally, last but not the least, please rate the course 5 stars, because it really motivates us guys to make more and more awesome videos for you and awesome courses for you guys. So that's pretty much it from my side in this video. Let's see you in the next one. Bye-bye.